Folks, Dr. Pritam Samant from Hinduja Hospital. I am a specialist in retinal diseases, and on the occasion of World Sight Day today, I'm going to talk to you all about something about diabetic retinopathy. Now, as we are aware that diabetes as a disease affects the eye in different forms. One of the most feared and one of the most severe forms of affection of diabetes to the eye is diabetic retinopathy. The other problems diabetes can cause in the eye is unstable refraction, where you can have change in glasses frequently. There is early cataract formation in the eye because of diabetes. People can get repeated infections like styes because of diabetes. There can be glaucoma, there can be paralysis of the eyes, or even the reduction in eye sensitivity. What our topic of discussion today is going to be diabetic retinopathy, which is what forms a part of my specialty. Now, diabetes itself is a huge burden on all the health facilities in the world. The WHO figures in 1995 were there were a total of 18 million people with diabetes. And what they estimate in next 12 years is by 2025, that figure is going to almost triple, as there are going to be 54 million diabetes patients. Hence, because the incidence of diabetes is going to increase, therefore, the people who are going to take retinopathy, whose eyes are going to be affected because of diabetes, is also on the rise. 20 years ago, diabetes was the 17th cause of blindness in India. It has already climbed to the 6th position. Today, diabetes is the 6th cause of blindness, and it is estimated that in the next decade, diabetes would most probably climb to the 2nd or the 3rd position as the cause of blindness in Indian population. The question in all our minds is, how common is diabetic retinopathy? How commonly a patient having diabetes would line up with diabetic retinopathy? Well, as you can see, the figure is around 25%. It is quite high. That means one in every four people who have diabetes will end up with their eyes affected with diabetic retinopathy. And this figure is much larger in those people who are type 1 diabetics, or the young population whose diabetes. In those, almost 100%, that means every young diabetes would be affected by diabetic retinopathy in some form or the other. So the figures are quite alarming. So how does diabetic retinopathy affect the eye? We broadly classify it as early stage diabetic retinopathy and advanced stage diabetic retinopathy. In the early stage, the diabetes affects the small blood vessels in the back of the eye. These are the retinal capillaries. However, in advanced stage, that means if this particular early stage is not detected and it is allowed to progress, then in the advanced stage, there is growth and extension of these new vessels in the eye, and that causes permanent loss of vision. So the early stage diabetic retinopathy is referred to as non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. And when it goes into the advanced stage, it is called as the proliferative diabetic retinopathy, or PDR. Now, this is just a diagrammatic representation of the eye, the eye which is shown in a cut section. So as you can see, this is the back part of the eye, that is a retina. So this retina acts as the film in a camera. So whenever our eye captures an image, it is processed in this retina, and then with the help of this nerve, it is sent to the brain. The front of the eye, that is a cornea and the lens, merely does the function of focusing the image on the retina. How does a retina look in an actual person? So when you see inside the eye, this is how the retina looks like. It has a yellowish orange color, and these are all the retinal blood vessels that you can see. And this in the center is the optic nerve. The optic nerve is the connection of the eye to the brain, which carries the information of the eye from the eye to the brain. Now this is a normal retina. Now let's see what happens when diabetic retinopathy affects the eye. Now if you can see here, you can see a few yellow spots on this retina. Now this is a patient in whom who has absolutely normal vision. we write at the right hand side corner, you can see 6 by 6. When we say 6 upon 6 or 6 by 6, it means 100% vision. So this is a patient who will not have complaints in the eye. This is a patient where we have diagnosed that diabetes has started affecting his eye, that is early diabetic retinopathy. In such a patient, it is very important to detect this problem and treat it well within time. However, if this particular form is not controlled, then it progresses to the late stage or the advanced stage. So if you can see a normal retina on this side, and you can see what has happened to the retina over here. All these yellow spots have increased. All these exudates have now plastered themselves to the retina. And you can see all these retinal hemorrhages. Now this particular patient can barely see about 3 meters from his into the distance. So his vision is only 3 by 60, which amounts to only about 20% vision. So this is a very advanced stage of diabetic retinopathy where the patient has almost become totally blind. If it is not controlled, then in the final stage, a huge blood clot, what is referred to as hemorrhage, appears inside the eye. And once the hemorrhage enters the eye, then the vision is completely lost. There is another patient, you can see here, where this white structure is the retina itself has come off from its position. Because of the blood clot, the retina has detached and it is called as retinal detachment. So how do we treat diabetic retinopathy or how do we diagnose it? Now, this is an instrument which is called as the fundus photograph or the digital fundus photography. We have one of the most latest state-of-the-art equipment with us at Hinduja Hospital, which looks something like this. So what does this equipment do? This equipment essentially takes photographs of the eye. This particular procedure is called FFA or fundus fluorescein angiography. Mind you, it is a simple outpatient procedure lasting about 15 to 20 minutes. The patient has to sit in front of the camera. We give an injection in the vein of the patient's hand and we take photographs sitting across the patient like this. A normal retina would appear something like this with all the blood vessels looking white in color. So this is a normal fundus fluorescein angiograph. But what would happen in a abnormal patient? There you see. This is a patient with diabetic retinopathy. So all these white spots you can see over here and you can see over here are those areas from where blood is leaking inside the eye of the patient. So we refer to these points as the leakage points. We call them new vessels in our terminology. When we detect this particular form of problem in the eye, then we diagnose that the patient has got diabetic retinopathy. The patient has a chance of losing his or her vision, and then this particular case has to be treated. What is the effect of diabetic retinopathy? How can we prevent these eyes from going blind? The gold standard of treating diabetic retinopathy is by doing laser. Now, as you know, laser itself, the word laser sounds as if it's a big procedure, but it is not. Again, laser is quite a simple outpatient procedure. It takes about 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes. Again, there are two or three types of lasers. There is a laser which is done in the sitting position like this, this person sitting over here, and I am giving the laser through a machine like this. It can be done in the lying position with the patient lying down and laser being delivered through a headgear. Or also during surgery, laser is being delivered in the eye of the patient. So these are the various types in which a laser can be delivered to the eye. Of course, while delivering the laser, you can see in the background over here, the doctor is delivering the laser to the patient's eye. And in the background, the monitor has the angiography pictures of the patient's eye. So laser is not a blind procedure, mind you. After taking out the angiography photograph, depending on the picture, what is there in the patient's eye, the laser has to be done. You can see a picture of the eye after the laser. This is how the retina looks. These yellow spots are the laser burns on the retina. They look black after a couple of days. So this is how the retina looks after laser. I'll give a simple example of a patient. Now, this was a patient on the left hand side. You can see a patient who came with these yellow exudates. This was, we detected the patient had diabetic retinopathy and we immediately did laser. You can see in the picture, left hand side lower corner, all the exudates have gone and the patient's eye has become normal. As against this patient who walked in our OD to our hospital with all these yellow spots and these red hemorrhages, in spite of giving laser, for some reason the patient didn't come back to us but did come back after 6 months and it has progressed to this level. So diabetic retinopathy treatment is to some extent a semi-urgent treatment. Unlike cataract is not an urgent problem. You can wait couple of days, couple of months, but once you develop diabetic retinopathy and once you're advised laser by your doctor, it will be done as early as possible. Now, what happens when the diabetic retinopathy reaches the advanced stage? So as you can see over here, once the diabetic retinopathy reaches this stage where a blood clot develops inside the eye or when the retina gets detached, then the person totally loses eyesight. That means it becomes absolutely blank in front of the eye. At this stage, laser does not help, unfortunately. In this advanced stage, the only alternative left with us is to do retinal surgery. This form of retinal surgery is called vitrectomy. Now here, this is just a diagrammatic representation of how we do vitrectomy. You can see the eye is shown in a cut section and we make these small holes just next to the eye over here, and with our micro instruments, mind you, this is a micro surgery, it has to be done with extreme precision. So these instruments are then introduced inside the eye and the surgery is performed. This is a vitrectomy surgery being done. Of course, the equipment required for retina surgery is a very complex equipment. On the left side, you can see this is how a vitrectomy machine looks like. This is one of another contraption which is attached to the microscope, because you need this kind of a special equipment to look inside the eye when you're doing surgery. Surgery is not possible without a good team. So you need good nursing assistants. You need good assists to help you in the operation theater. So it requires a large team of doctors helping you to do this kind of complex procedures. I'm going to show you a short video of how this of retinal surgery is carried out for patients having diabetic problems. As you can see, we introduce these instruments inside the eye. We make small openings inside, and these instruments are introduced next to the eye, and you can see the curve inside the eye. So what you're seeing here is a membrane being dissected from the retina. Mind you, these instruments which you're seeing here are barely a few millimeters in size. So this is what looked is microsurgery in progress inside the eye. Now, as you know, medical science progresses from leaps and bounds. So what is new? Even in diabetic retinopathy, even in patients having eye problems because of diabetic retinopathy, newer advances have come, and we are lucky to have all these newer advances with us at Hinduja Hospital. What is new right now is the full form is optical coherence tomography. I'm sure all of you are aware that we do a CT scan of the brain. When we do a CT scan of the brain, what it shows us is a cut section of the brain. OCT is another is a test which actually shows us the retina in cut section. So this is how the OCT shows us. What's seeing here, the eye, which is seen in a cut section, it shows so many details of the retina that is it actually you can compare it to a microscopic picture under a microscope of the retina. All those layers which you can microscopically see are seen in the OCT. How does this help us? Well, you can see over here, there are these two pictures. This is the OCT before taking treatment. You can see it is like bulging here. The retina is bulged up like a mountain because this person has diabetic retinopathy and has lost his vision. And this is before taking laser. After taking laser, 3 months after laser, you can see the retina has gone back in its normal architecture. You can see this nice curve, smooth curve which has come back to the retina after laser. So OCT helps us study the retina before and after treatment, and it tells us whether our treatment has become successful or not. The advantage of OCT, unlike angiography, is you don't have to inject any injection. OCT is just a simple photograph of the eye and does not take more than a minute or two. We are fortunate at Hinduja to have the latest form of OCT that is called as a spectral domain OCT. The spectral domain OCT allows us to see up to 5 microns resolution. You can imagine 5 microns. I'm talking about 1/1000th of a millimeter. So up to 5 microns you can see inside the eye. I'm going to show you what wonders this spectral OCT can do. You can see over here. Now, what I'm showing you is not the caste plateau of Panchgani or Mahabaleshwar, but this is actually the cut section of the retina which the OCT machine has photographed. And you can see this red portion is the bulge in the retina. This is the bulge in the retina, or the swelling which has occurred because of diabetic retinopathy. And once treatment is done, then see how it has flattened now. This is the picture of the retina in the entire retina after the treatment. It has become absolutely flat after the treatment. So this particular equipment has added a lot of value to the retina practice. Like I mentioned, there are other things which are new. Now, sometimes laser doesn't work stage, then laser doesn't help. Nowadays, there are these injections which have come in the market, and these injections, if given inside the eye, work wonders. These injections are known to actually reverse damage which occurs in diabetic retinopathy. So there is the injection triamcinolone alone, which we give inside the eye. There are other injections. There is another injection called as Lucentis. There is one more injection called Macugen. There is also an injection called Avastin. So these injections are to be given inside the eye. Mind you, we put anesthetic drops in the eye so that the injection is as painless as possible. But the only problem with these injections is the injection has a certain limited life inside the eye. So these injections may have to be repeated every month till the problem is cured. So while some patients require only injections, there are other patients who may require up to 4 or 5 injections also. Here there is one more photograph. This is again a patient. The photograph on the top is showing an OCT of a patient who had this swelling in the retina before the injection. And after 6 months after giving the injection, you can see the retina has flattened out. So these injections do work wonders in many of the patients. The last but not the least, cataract surgery became sutureless about 10 years ago. That means you would have gone to your cataract doctor, he would have said that abhi hum taka nahi lete, abhi cataract operation bina taake ka hota hai. Well, guess what? In the last 2 or 3 years, even retinal surgery has become sutureless. Previously, after retinal surgery, the patient used to have a lot of itching, a lot of redness. The patient could not go back to work for almost a month, month and a half. But now, the retinal surgery also has become sutureless. The patient hardly has a watering eye or a red eye after operation. It is absolutely comfortable. And within 10 to 15 days, the patient can join back work. And this is something very dear to my heart, because Hinduja Hospital was one of the first corporate hospitals to introduce sutureless retinal surgery 3 years ago. I'm just going to show you a small video clip of how this surgery is done. It is quite interesting to see this. Now, as you can see over here, you can see in the center of the eye, you can see this yellow in the front is the eye because of diabetes problem. So in what we do in surgery is we put the small peak by the side. These are called as trocars. Barely 1/4 of a millimeter in size, and through this hole you have to serve the instruments inside the eye. You're seeing now is inside the eye, and my instrument is now sucking all the blood which is there inside the eye. You can see the retina over there with the blood sitting on it, and our microscopic instruments are now sucking all the blood from the retina. You can see the slowly the laser being done through these same instruments. And at the end of the instrument, the most amazing thing is you just simply have to pull out these small hooks out. That's it. There is no need for taking any sutures, and the eye looks absolutely the way it was before surgery. So just to tell you that medical science has come a long way and has worked a lot of wonders. Finally, I would like to conclude by telling some important points, because you know, after so much of giving you so much in a couple of minutes, what is important here to remember, for especially for patients, is that every eye with normal vision may have changes of diabetic retinopathy. So don't think that if you're a diabetic patient and if your vision is normal, does not mean that your eye does not have diabetic retinopathy. To start with, even in diabetic retinopathy, the person sees normally, and it is at this stage that if it is detected, then there is a best chance of doing treatment and preserving your vision. So diabetic retinopathy treatment is all about preserving your vision before you go blind. The second important point to remember is most of the patients, when I tell them that they have diabetic retinopathy in the eye, the first thing they tell is, lekin doctor saab, mera blood sugar gaye 2 saal se normal hai. So it is not necessary that if your blood sugar is normal, that means your eye will not get affected. No. Even with a normal blood sugar, a person may develop diabetic retinopathy inside the eye. Hence, every diabetic should get their eyes checked at least once. And when we talk about eye check, we don't mean walking across to an optical shop and getting your eye checked. What I mean by eye check is a proper complete eye checkup, where we put dilatation drops inside the eye and we check the inside of the eye with an instrument called as ophthalmoscope. And last but not the least, I've shown you so much about laser and surgery, but remember, laser and surgery is meant to arrest the disease, and in some cases, in spite of treatment, diabetic retinopathy can progress. So that also has to be kept in mind. This is the picture, as you can see here, of an institute called a Shankar Netralaya in Madras. This is the parent institute where I did my retinal surgery training from. So I always salute this institute, because it is in hospitals and institutes like this that are doing fantastic job of training surgeons all over India in this particular field of vitreoretinal speciality. Many thanks. Thank you. So can we answer it? Type this. I can see it, or yeah. I believe there was a question saying that can diabetic retinopathy surgery completely cure the problem? Well, the answer is yes and no. What I mean is, it depends on the stage the diabetic retinopathy has reached. If there is a bleeding inside the eye and the retina behind the blood is in good health, then diabetic retinopathy can restore the original sight. If, however, there is bleeding inside the eye, but the retina behind the blood has already become very, very weak, it has lost its power or energy, then diabetic retinopathy surgery will barely restore about 10-15% vision. It will not give you back your 100% eyesight. It will not give you back the eyesight required to do for reading newspaper or for reading, because these activities require 100% eyesight. So diabetic retinopathy surgery, mind you, is to restore partial or good amount of vision. In all cases, it may not restore 100% vision. I believe there was one more problem which said, what are the symptoms of diabetic retinopathy? That means what? How will a patient know that he has diabetic retinopathy? I mentioned in my presentation that not all patients will realize that they have diabetic retinopathy. You may be having diabetic retinopathy and you may be having normal vision. Hence, it is important to regularly get your eyes checked by an eye doctor. But in the advanced stages, yes. The first thing what you'll see in diabetic retinopathy is you might see black spots floating in front of your eye. They're called as floats. These black spots are those small red blood vessels which are floating, blood cells which are floating inside your eye. In the late stages, your vision will start dropping. Firstly, you'll won't be able to read small print. And secondly, you'll start seeing black patches in front of your eyes. And you will even stop seeing a person in front of you. And in the final stages, the eye goes completely blind. So this is how the symptoms of diabetic retinopathy progress. No, all patients of diabetes will not get diabetic retinopathy. Like I said in my presentation, the percentage is 25%. That means one in every four diabetes patients will develop diabetic retinopathy. This is true for elderly diabetics, but the type 1 diabetic patients, that means the younger diabetics, or we call it juvenile onset diabetes, in these patients, that figure is much higher. It is said that almost 100% or maybe at least 3 out of 4 young diabetic patients will develop diabetic